Hare Krishna. I hope you had a good day today. We actually wanted to hear a few reflections from all the devotees. So we will go around the room so that some devotees want to leave, so maybe they can give their reflections and then they can go and take rest. Because I know some devotees didn't get sleep for past 2 days, so maybe they can give their reflections. And you can just say, how was the day, what stuck with you, or some realization that you had today.
Hare Krishna. This is my first time distributing. My name is Shamya Prasadas. This is my first time distributing Bhagavatam sets door to door. I was in Mother Malini's team, the Nityananda team. And, you know, we knocked on 4, 5, 6 doors, and there was some sort of interested people. They took a couple of Bhagavad Gitas, but not really, you know, much sign of a Bhagavatam. And then we walked down the street, and the first, we just saw this lady in her driveway, and she was on her cell phone, and she said, "Oh, hello. Oh, that's my husband pulling up just now." Turns out they were a really nice Bengali family. Husband was coming with the son, and it came out over the course of the conversation that, one, they're good friends with the devotee who comes to this temple, and they've known him since 1991. Two, the gentleman's grandmother and grandfather were Vaishnavs. In fact, they had taken an initiation in the Gaudiya line from a godbrother of Srila Prabhupada. Three, he himself had some affection for Krishna, and especially Balaram, because his grandmother was a devotee of Lord Balaram, but he didn't feel himself qualified to worship Krishna or consider himself a Vaishnava. In fact, he pulled out the seventh canto when we showed it to him. He said, "Do you see this person on Nrsingadev's lap? This is me. I'm Hiranyakashipu." He was very funny. Four, it was his wife's birthday on Nrsingha Chaturdashi. Five, today is his wedding anniversary. It's her wedding anniversary. Six, today is the 12th day from the passing of that same grandmother, the very day when the funeral arrangements or different kinds of arrangements must be made. And therefore, he was very emotional, although he was trying to be very stoic about it. And he said that, "For a long time, I've heard from my friend I should come to the temple. I want to come. I don't feel qualified." And he tried to put up some resistance, but Mother Malini would not have it. And all the coincidences were too much for his wife, who said, "We must have this." Anyway, they invited us inside. We had a kirtan. They took the said, gave $300 for it. And we were crying. Everybody was crying. It was such an amazing thing. I couldn't have scripted it like that. And what's more, he was telling us stories about his grandmother's devotion to Lord Balaram, and it occurred to me that our team's name is Team Nityananda. So the entire thing felt like Balaram was reclaiming one of his devotees that had kind of gone away from the practice of devotional service. And he was telling us, "There was some disagreement with my grandmother. We didn't get along, although we loved each other very much." There was something there, he said, with his tears in his eyes. And they were very happy to take the Bhagavatam. They read a verse, and they promised to read more and come to the temple. And my realization was that there is absolutely no way that I could have imagined anything better than what Lord Chaitanya had planned out for us. And that was the first Bhagavatam set to go. We did two more after that. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So today for me was also extremely blissful, and likewise, I've never been really door-to-door Srimad Bhagavatam set distribution before. It was a first, and just gradually through the course of the day, I could tell in myself and the other devotees I was with that the energy really picks up. There's certainly like some manifestation of the internal energy making everyone feel extremely surcharged with energy and happiness and enthusiasm, confidence. You know, most of us in the party were not ready to knock on the door right away, but after an hour of seeing Vital Prabhu show us, actually we were quite all eager. We were kind of all wanting to get to the door first, and Yeah, it was just really nice encountering people. And I also kind of had a few similar instances, just seeing people walking to and from their cars. I stopped one man, and a Western-bodied man, and gave him a Bhagavad Gita, and he said that he just started listening to some meditation lectures. And he said, "How much?" And I said, "Anything." And he said, "No, how much?" And I said, $5. And he said, "Well, that's exactly what I have." And that's all I had. And whenever that stuff happens, they become their faith increases, because they're like, wow, this is kind of mystical. It was meant to be. And yeah, it was just really nice to see that all the devotees, you know, from ISV, really show just such staunch enthusiasm and determination to distribute sets, despite different people, you know, spending half an hour, 45 minutes trying to distribute, and then them turning out to not take it. Just that persistence is really inspiring. Sometimes on street sankirtan, I feel you really have to kind of be a lion, or you have to be quite aggressive, street sankirtan. But I realize that actually the devotees here distributing sets have definitely got us beat, because really, I don't know how many no's. There's never any amount of no's I won't take that can deter these sankirtan warriors. So thank you for showing me the way and inspiring me to do this myself. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Prabhu. We will have the new devotees first go around, and then we can have reflections from ISP devotees also. But first, let's go with the devotees who registered.
So I had a very good day, very wonderful day. It was very blissful. As usual, book distribution is always very learning, very purifying. And so I had two major realizations today. The very first thing was actually Mali Mataji was saying that Srimad Bhagavatam is Krishna itself, and he decides the house where he wants to go in. And that's what I realized when the very first house we knocked into. And she said that my sister, she's already been practicing and she's in Philadelphia. Her brother goes to Nashik temple every time. And that's when we realized, oh, this family is completely ripened one. And that's why Krishna gave us that call, and we knocked at this door and we are here. And they were very receptive, and we could give the Srimad Bhagavatam to them. And then same thing happened in the next house as well. So their family was still very pious. They came, the lineage was from the priest. And the Mataji's family was Shaivite, and they were the priest in Andhra Pradesh. So I think we did not take even 5 minutes, and then they said, oh, I really want to take the Srimad Bhagavatam. Where it is. And we showed them. Priyakishori did amazing kirtan at their place. He really felt very nice. And Mataji was going through some vertigo, but still she was like, I really want to hear, but I can't stand. I don't know, I'm just missing out so much. But it was so good. So I realized, yes, Srimad Bhagavatam will go only where Krishna thinks that the person is ready, and he decides the place. And they were saying, so there was one more catch to it. So they were saying, today morning we recited some Govindam prayers. And they said, oh, that's why we are here. Like, you know, Krishna decided, oh, that's why not let the devotees go here and distribute the Srimad Bhagavatam. So this was my first realization. Second realization I learned was, so we went to a Jain family as a third home. And she was pretty receptive. She did not have a blockage in her mind. So then Hari Vamsha Prabhu, actually, he discussed about Rishabhdev. So that's how I realized, like, if you have to approach to any Jain family or anybody who is little receptive, who comes from Jain background, you can talk about Rishabhdev from fifth canto. And that's how they actually start connecting to you. So this was one of my realization. And then we met a person on the road. He was pretty humble. He was very receptive to SKCON. But so one more thing I also realized, like, where you should keep a stop. You should you would know, like, how to realize, like, whether it's a ripened soul or an unripened soul. And just you should move ahead. Tell him or her in succinct, in a small, summarized way, and you would realize that okay, maybe he's just kind of want to just move ahead. So then that's where you have to put stop, just not go on bothering him. That was my realization. Learned a lot. Thank you, Mataji.
You want to say one thing?
There are too many people I can talk.
Okay.
So we had really very nice day today, and I'm so thankful that Krishna made me part of this day where I could go and experience. So we went to, we were able to get one Bhagavatam set, the very first house we went, and first they were like, we don't have time to read, and you know, my kids are not ready, I don't think I'm ready, but still he was listening to our conversation that we kept doing, and Shraddha Mataji did excellent job on, you know, convincing him and talking, and then he finally decided that yes, he wanted, and he got one Bhagavatam set. So that was really very nice, made me very happy. We went down a few streets, and we were able to, few houses wanted some Bhagavad Gitas, so we were able to give them some Bhagavad Gitas, and few of them just gave donation. They said they had enough books and they don't want to read, but they were happy to give some kind of donation. So it was awesome, and I look forward for many more such days. Thank you.
Hare Krishna, all glories to the assembled devotees, all glories to Srila Prabhupada. I was with Malini Mataji's team, and this is the first time I had ever been on door-to-door Bhagavatam distribution. Unbelievable, blissful experience, had some highs and lows, but I was really impressed with how Mataji and the team, their depth of knowledge, on a personal level, it revealed to me how shallow my understanding is of the scriptures, and especially Srimad Bhagavatam. So I'm hoping I can, you know, introspect a little more after this trip and really buckle down. It's time to get serious about our own sadhana if we're going to be able to go on door to door. So that was really revealed to me because they were able to have such amazing personal connections. It's one thing to see it on a PowerPoint slide, but the way that they were, you know, professionally and politely and respecting everyone's, you know, beliefs and backgrounds, it was very impressive. So I'm hoping to take that away from these few days of seminars, is trying to really dig deep for our own sadhana just by learning from all of you. So I could probably go on for hours, but I'll go ahead and pass the torch. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. I was part of Harivansha Prabhu's team. Mataji was also, I was in the same team with Mataji, so she shared some realizations already. But I think it was a pretty good day. The one thing that I realized is that there was a lot of energy in the devotees to distribute books, and especially Bhagavatam sets. I wouldn't have imagined that we would distribute, like all the teams would distribute 12 sets just in a day. That's like, I think in 4 months in Connecticut, we distribute just one Bhagavatam set. So you can imagine. So I was really surprised that we can distribute 12 sets in just a day. So there was a lot of energy and people were really determined. Harivansha Prabhu, especially, he was really good the way he was talking. Mataji talked about the family from Andhra Pradesh. So that Prabhuji was really, as if he was waiting for someone to come and like give Bhagavatam to him. And then, when we stood up and we just started walking out, he actually started touching our feet. So I was like, we were a little surprised. He was too humble and he was feeling very excited, or, very fortunate to get Srimad Bhagavatam. So, of course, we had some other experiences also, like one Prabhuji, he just directly said, I'm not planning to buy anything today. So that discussion just ended, I would say, in 30 seconds maybe. So, there was those kind of experiences also, but I think mostly it was good. I think just one person did not buy any books. Otherwise, I believe our team, every house we knocked, we gave at least one Bhagavad Gita or one Krishna book or a Bhagavatam set. So I think it was good overall.
I was also on Team Nityananda with Malini Prabhu and Sri Kumar Prabhu, and it was really fascinating for me to watch because I've never also been on full set distribution door-to-door before. And I thought it's probably, you know, not too hard to distribute the Bhagavatam if you're an Indian and you're distributing it to Indians, but I was completely wrong. And at least for me, it looked like Malini and Sri Kumar Prabhu were so patient. I kept waiting for them to give up. And it wasn't like they were being pushy or persistent. They were just being patient. They waited till the person ran out of, you know, they just kept saying, okay. And just making friends. From the very moment they started talking to them, they were just making friends with them. And that's all they were doing. There was no motive, passion involved at all, which is what I'm like on street Sankirtan or any Sankirtan. And I was just amazed. And like, so after the first set was distributed to people I thought would never take it, then the second person that I could tell they just settled in and... You just settled in and started talking, and the person, I kept thinking we weren't going to stay there long, and then I realized, okay, this is what you do, and so I just settled in and watched it unfold, and it was just so amazing to me how you, like, got them to the point of being friends, and then, of course, it was a natural thing to want to take it. It was such a lesson to me, and I really appreciate all the association, all the devotees were so sweet today, and I'm just going to learn to be patient and make friends. I think that's the key, and it really surprised me that it was so difficult to just keep countering. But the thing is, you didn't counter them. This is what I really loved, is everyone just, you kept agreeing with them. Everything they said, you agreed with and said, okay. And then you just stayed, and then you just started talking about something else, and then you were like, okay. And then you kept talking about other things, so it was amazing how deft you were, and I really appreciate it. Thank you. Sorry if I took too long.
I was on Mataji Shraddha's team, and I've never done door-to-door book distribution either, but I kind of had a plan, and my plan was to hang back behind the crowd, and I could just listen to everyone. But after some time, they were like, okay, your turn, and gave me the book. So then it's like, oh no, I didn't know I was going to have to talk to people. I've never tried to sell a set of Bhagmatams before, so I really had to dig deep to figure out what I was going to say to people. And I just thought, no, it's not really trying to figure out what to say to people. It's really just speaking from your heart and trying to make some kind of connection. Our group did sell one set of Bhagmatams, and it was to the very first house that we went to, which made me believe that, wow, this is great. Like, you just go to the door and knock and talk to the person, and they write the check and give you the Bhagmatams. But then we didn't sell another one after that, but we were really happy that we had just at least distributed one. And the best part I liked is after the person said yes, we went into their home and offered it nicely to them, and all the kids took turns reading from the Bhagmatam, and then the parents took turns reading from the Bhagmatam, and you could really see how, to me, it just looked like that their lives were already changing because they've got the Bhagmatam set and they're now together on the spiritual path. So that left a lasting impression with me. And I also learned that the word, two words, the spiritual investment can go a long way. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you for this very lovely experience. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. This was my first time going on book distribution, and it was very, very, I learned a lot from this experience, actually. So I was with Shraddha Mataji's group, and the first house we went to, we were able to distribute a Bhagavatam set. And it was actually, it was very interesting because the man at first, he would listen to what Shraddha Mataji would say, but I could see it, like, he had doubt in his mind. He didn't really want to buy it. And slowly and slowly, after listening more and more, like, he eventually decided, okay, I will buy a set. And then after we properly went into his house and gave it to him, he started to ask questions himself. So it was really interesting seeing how, like, with just within that one distribution, like, the change I saw in him. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, all devotees. I was also part of Shraddha Mataji and Mukharvind Prabhu's team. I had a really blissful time today. As everybody said, we did one set today. But beside all the aspects, I really liked the aspect of how organized everything was, you know. Means the books were there, the water was there. And beside that, when we were delivering messages to the people, and if one person stopped, immediately other devotees from the team immediately picked up, you know. So it was pretty nice, you know. Means we kept saying things, and then ultimately he got the Bhagavatam set. So it was very wonderful and very nice. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, I was part of Haradhar Prabhu's team. Hare Krishna, I was part of Haradhar Prabhu's team. It was a wonderful experience. we did not have any success, but that's a different story altogether. But it was very, very learning and very enlivening experience for me. I'm very grateful for Haradhar Prabhu, Kumari Lilla Mataji, and a couple of other people also, devotees also. Two experiences especially. One is, as Prabhuji mentioned, that going in a group is always very, very helpful. We cannot fight this Srila Prabhupada's war alone as a single soldier. We really have to go in an army. That was very, very good experience. Of course, whenever we start speaking to people, we cannot keep on talking. We have to stop. We have to ask other people to some questions. And so as a group, it was really one wonderful experience. The other thing was seeing how devotees are so patient in giving that compassion. They are not hurrying to just distribute the book and go away. They are taking time because it's Srila Prabhupada's compassion. And that's getting extended through us being an instrument. So it was very, very nice to see see devotees doing this thing very patiently. It definitely touched me because I see a lot of patience lacking in me. So seeing people doing this thing very patiently, that was very good thing. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mother. Hare Krishna. I was originally on the Chaitanya team with, I believe it's Sri Krishna Purushottama Prabhu. However, when we got to our destination in Pleasanton, there seemed to be a larger number of devotees, so I ended up getting the mercy of being on Ramasundar Prabhu's team with some other very wonderful devotees. This is my first time going out to distribute Bhagavatams. I'd been on door-to-door book distribution just a couple times before, but this was a really very inspiring experience. I was really, really inspired by a lot of what these other Prabhus mentioned about how organized the whole plan was. The Prabhus knew exactly what streets they'd already been to before. They knew where the Bhagavatams were. And they, what also really inspired me too was not just how much knowledge all of these Prabhus had about the Bhagavatam, but how much love they had for glorifying the Bhagavatam. And that was the whole plan, was just to glorify the Bhagavatam and let other people know about how glorious this literature is and to inspire them to welcome it in their lives. And we ended up distributing one Bhagavatam set to this very wonderful Mataji and her family, as well as some other Bhagavad Gita's and Krishna books. And it was just overall very, very inspiring. And I'm hoping that from this experience, like you mentioned, Prabhu, that I can become also inspired to have stronger, more sincere, more strict sadhana to be able to go out and distribute these books and share this mercy that we've gotten. And I thank all the devotees here at ISV for giving us this opportunity to go out on this. So thank you.
Hare Krishna. I was on the Gadadhar team, and we just had a wonderful experience. I could see so many of the concepts presented in the seminars. I could see them practically happening in front of me, just like the ripe fruit theory, and I could see who was the ripe fruit and who wasn't. And we were very fortunate that the first house we went to, it was a good start. They didn't take a set, but they took a Bhagavad Gita. Then the following house was a very nice family, and they invited us in, and they were really curious about the Bhagavatam. And the devotees were just glorifying the Bhagavatam for maybe 45 minutes. We did a very wonderful kirtan, and I could see that it really changed the mood. The kirtan really helped as well, doing some kirtan. And I could also see the four laws really take place, how important the four laws of book distribution are, and how one should really understand what they're distributing before they start distributing. It's really nice to know the pastimes of the Lord and explain them to these different families that grew up in this background. Even if they didn't, it's very nice to understand what we're distributing before we go out and distribute. So kind of those different concepts I saw fall into place, and it was just really ecstatic when they said, okay, yes, we'll take it. And they started, they pull out their checkbook or their credit card, and they said, yes, of course, we'll give $250. And they weren't hesitant. It was really mystical to see that. And another thing I really liked, last point, is that the analogy that the Bhagavatam is just like Lord Krishna, and we can't separate his different bodily limbs. And so they explain how the first two cantos are like his lotus feet, all the way up to his lotus face, the 10th canto, and so on. So it's really nice. Some people said, okay, we'll just take one. So we said, well, we can't separate Krishna's limbs. This is a deity of Krishna. So you have to, even if you don't read it, you can have Krishna and worship him in your house. And that really convinced them. So it was just a really nice day. I really appreciate all of your association. You're all such wonderful devotees. And I feel really blessed and grateful. Thank you.
Hare Krishna, everyone. I was fortunate enough to be with the Advaita team, which was led by Vitthal Prabhu. And if success has to be measured by the amount of Bhagavatam we distributed, so we were a flop. But if you measure with the yardstick of how much I learned and how much I was able to appreciate Srila Prabhupada's mission and the devotees who are dedicating their life, it was an eye-opener for me. And although with the theory part was good, but I was able to see in practical way how the devotees apply those things, because every time we knocked the door, I would like, after a minute, I would think, now it's done, the deal is finished, we are just, I would like back up, but I would see Vittal, like the person would be closing the door, but he's just talking, and like the door would again open. And he would continue, and they'd say, no, we have this. And he'd say, okay, then this. And we were able to distribute Krishna book and Bhagavad Gita. And people were receptive in that way. But the best part was, as many devotees said, I saw how Srimad Bhagavatam was being glorified, which I never thought. I would read that Srimad Bhagavatam is the cream and is the best knowledge. But when I saw the devotees explaining, and you can see that genuine description through their eyes, I could appreciate what I guess is written. I have not read them myself fully, I should admit. And the best part was which I carry with me is when one of the Indian family said they don't have space in their home. And Vitthal Prabhu explained it very nicely that Srimad Bhagavatam is the king of knowledge. And he gave a very nice analogy. He said, like in Jagannath Puri, all the people are there for Lord Jagannath, and the king also comes as a sweeper. And despite the whole area being packed, when the king comes, there's a little bit of space is made, so the king can sweep. So similarly, Srimad Bhagavatam is the king. So even though you don't have a space, when the king comes, you make a space. And it just struck me. And I think, I mean, this was the best part. Although we were not successful, but it just struck me in my heart that how beautifully it was being glorified, and how perseverant Prabhu was. And he never gave up. And I was feeling bad at one point, like, Krishna, please at least one for the sake of... But then I realized it's good that we are not being able to do it, because it is teaching me new tricks, because I could see, because had one Bhagavatam set gone, and we would have been complacent, because we were, by Krishna's mercy, none of them went. So we were just exploring, and I was able to see new tricks from the bag of Vitthal Prabhu, that how he was turning the conversations, and how every time he was accepting, appreciating what the other person was saying, although it may be wrong, and he would turn it around and glorify Srimad Bhagavatam again and again. And at the end, I was fortunate enough to join Purushottam Prabhu, and when he was installing Srimad Bhagavatam at someone's house, and I saw how it was not just, okay, we got the check, so we have to just do some show off ceremony and run away. He did very sincerely, he did the installation, although it was a 5 or 10 minute ceremony, but that family, I could see they were so satisfied, and it was like a lifetime impact. I think they will definitely come to the temple, and it was very educational, inspiring. I'm lost of words to describe. Hari Bol.
You're the only one left. You're the only one, Anshul. That's it.
Hare Krishna. So I was with... I was at Fremont with Malini Mataji, Shiva Prabhu, and the team. And lots to learn, of course. I had been dreaming about this day for the last few weeks since I knew I was coming here. So dreams come true for sure.
Put your mic closer to you.
Sure. So a few things I learned was it all came down to how hard we prayed, and I could see devotees' prayers were being answered. And through their sincerity, Krishna was really testing us. So we had a variety of exchanges, we would say, through the doors, and we could see the complexities. You know, some of them are really easy. The last one we went to was, you know, Krishna's mercy throughout, due to our dedication and persistence of the devotees. You know, Krishna gave us an easy one, if you may, the last one. And so I'm taking away that with me, the sincerity and praying hard as one factor. And the second thing I really appreciate and would like to take back to Toronto is the level of organization you have here at ISV, which really assists the book distributors to do their task, so they can, you know, freely distribute books and not worry about all the supporting requirements when you go out. Thank you very much for organizing this, and we hope to take what you've taught us far and beyond. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Sorry. Thank you. Sorry. As for many of you went on sets distribution for the first time, so it was first time for me also. In Toronto, we've been trying to go out on door-to-door often, but we never really got into doing sets. And this was one of our goals, to learn how to do sets coming to ISV. And I was really amazed and stunned by, you know, seeing devotees being able to do sets. Because all this while we thought, you know, sets mean so only in temple it might happen when they come and speak to devotees. But this was something which, you know, it was magical to experience devotees being so enthusiastic in doing sets. So I was with Krishna Purushottam Prabhu, and he just something else. He keeps speaking to them, and they're truly convinced when they take it that this book is going to help me. And that's something which was really close to unbelievable, to see that it can happen, and we just need to try being out there. And I think that will be one of big takeaways for me personally, to just go there and try it in Toronto. We've been trying, I think in the last 1 month we've been speaking a lot about doing sets this year, since it was one of our goals, and it's been already 4 months, so we were sort of, you know, looking back and seeing what are we doing, and we thought maybe coming here might help. And we're really truly grateful to devotees at ISV for organizing it so nicely, and you know, giving an opportunity for so many other devotees all across North America trying to do this. So thanks to all of you all for making this happen. We really hope that we are able to do something like this in Toronto, even if not to the great extent you do. So at least something, and we really seek all your blessings so that we are able to do this back there. That's what Radhamohan Prabhu and Shyamamani Mataji, who are heading the Sankirtan there, they had such high hopes in sending us. it's a big pressure, you know. we were quite happy, oh, we're going to San Francisco. We'll do this, we'll do that. But it was truly amazing. So it was a wonderful day, and we're really, really grateful to all the association and support and encouragement from all of you all. So we humbly seek your blessing so that we're able to do something there. So thank you. Hare Krishna.
Did you go? Hare Krishna. I just wanted to thank you all for holding this program. I feel like truly blessed.
Close.
I'm sorry?
Close, Prabhuji.
Oh.
It has
oh.
to be closed.
Oh, sorry. I feel honestly truly blessed to be here right now amongst the devotees and the beautiful deities ISV. And today on books, I was very, very inspired by the way everything was just smooth and clear, and I really want to read more Bhagavatam now. yes, very good thing. To keep it in simple words, I'm just very inspired, very, very inspired. I can't thank you guys enough here for the hospitality and the sweetness. It's just amazing, just very short and sweet.
Hare Krishna. Thank you so much. I am also very grateful. And today, are we sharing our realizations, what we learned, things like that? Chai. Such a wonderful day. And although it was so long, it didn't really seem like that we were working so hard. I really did just feel the mercy of the truth that Krishna already knows where he wants to go, where, you know, and we're just trying to facilitate that. And the families that have now Srimad Bhagavatam in their home, I mean, it's so sweet to be able to participate in the installation, in their welcoming Srimad Bhagavatam into their home. The families that had children, and there was one family, there was a boy that was 6, and he was so excited. And the way that, you know, showed that was, you know, running around. And but he would say, it just, to me, I just think it's really beautiful that now he's so excited to have Srimad Bhagavatam class so that his mother can read him, you know, and he can hear more stories of Krishna. And that's Krishna's mercy, and it's so sweet. So I'm very much inspired to go back to San Diego and start distributing Srimad Bhagavatam class, because I see how possible it is. It's very doable. We just have to bring the sets out, right? We just have to go out and do it. Get books, make sure your sadhana is strong, you know, get up early, go out, and be persistent. Because that was also another surprise, because I don't think I ever considered it before, how to distribute a set of Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavatam, and it's, well, you have to present for some time, because people don't necessarily want to just accept it right away. But that's nice. We can make friends. We can have a conversation. We can get to know each other. And I think that that also has so much to do with building a strong community. And that it's just, there's so much. So I appreciate the day, and I'm looking forward to tomorrow. And thank you so much for hosting all of us and to have this opportunity. Because actually, some months back, I was wanting to come up here specifically to train in book distribution, but it was just, well, how to do that? But here, here's the opportunity. So thank you so much.
I think we are, did we miss anyone? Can we take like two more reflections from ISV devotees? If anybody wants to share. Actually, I just, everybody was saying that they had everything was so smooth. I don't know if Rajesh Prabhu is here, but the Vaisheshika Prabhu said the difficult part, most difficult part of doing Sankirtan is a troop movement. And Rajesh Prabhu and Kumari Leela were working really hard to make it smooth. So I don't know where he is, but everybody can thank him for... And the lunches, breakfast, and the dinner, wonderful dinner that we had, was cooked by Hansapriya Mataji, Her Grace Nirakul Mataji, and Her Grace Jagarini Mataji. So if you see them, don't forget to thank them. If you enjoyed the prasadam, of course. And also, any of ISV devotees, two reflections anybody wants to share? Shraddha Mataji.
Hare Krishna. I had actually gone there in the role of a leader and with the intentions of teaching. But I actually ended up learning from both Banki Bihari Mataji, Asit Prabhu, Jalpa Mataji, and as well as their son. And it was amazing. Like, you know, Mukharvind and I mostly do corporate book distribution, so we don't go out door to door that much, and we are kind of mostly on our own. So it was so refreshing for us to see other devotees do the book distribution, picking up some catchphrases over there. And the way Jalpa Mataji was able to always correlate with her life experiences of having brought a child up here in America and how Bhagavatam can play a role. And Yash, their son, was a little shy in the beginning, but then later on, as it caught up, as the day progressed, he was, you know, he went and presented the Bhagavatam set as well. And he was so meticulous about reminding us all the time that we had prasadam, that we should distribute prasadam as well. So he'd be like, and at one place there was a home where they had two kids, and then first he took out one brownie, and then he took out another one, which was a bigger one, and he said, they have two kids, I think they need the bigger brownie. And I was like, only a kid can think that way, you know. We look at a brownie and we are like, oh, there's so much sugar in it, and you know, we look at that. So that was amazing. And from Banki Bihari Mataji, she just went there, and some of the phrases that she used, for example, she would come and say like, oh, we are going here door to door to meet fortunate souls. And I was like, yes, indeed, these are fortunate souls, you know, who have opened the door and have agreed to listen to us. And she came up with this term, and I think it's true, because and she's coming from Canada, so she's the one who can think about it. She said, we're having an international festival. And yes, it is international that way. And Asit Prabhu, in the first home that we went, we were able to, after a lot of convincing, we were able to dispute a Bhagavatam set to them. The person asked so many questions. And then in the end, he said that, but my father says that this world is going to come to an end in 30 years. So, you know, how do I explain that? I go to Chinmaya Mission, I go to this. And then Asit Prabhu, you know, he's very calm and quite very reasonable. And I learned how to be rational and rationalize things and put things in the right manner there. And he just said that, you know, but what's the sampradaya for Chinmaya Mission? And I was like, that was a winner, you know, that was a winner for us. So I just learned from so many of them. So I'm so thankful that I went with them. Thank you for teaching me that.
So Rajesh Prabhu is back. So if you don't know who was Rajesh Prabhu, this is Rajesh Prabhu. He was assisted by book loading. You are seeing everything seamless because book loading, packing, everything is done by Vishwanath Prabhu, then Ram Sundar Prabhu, Haladara Prabhu, and where is Vinayak Prabhu? Vinayak Prabhu? Yes, Vinayak Prabhu. They're in the back row, all the back row you see, you know. Actually, though it was, Prabhu, one last. Though it was, you might be thinking that we did really good, but actually it was your association. The reason it is because this is the first time at ISP we distributed 12 Bhagavatam sets door to door. So actually the energy that all of you brought in actually inspired us also to do more. So actually we are grateful to all of you for helping us to do more sets. And you also saw something, we hope that you can take it back and come again and again so that we can distribute more here also. Sorry, Rajesh.
Just wanted to share today's realization. It is very interesting actually. I mean, we always think, okay, I distributed Srimad Bhagavatam. I think this is absolutely wrong. If you have any doubt, I can correlate with today's instance. The first one is, I know somebody who is my son's friends, you know, family. So we thought, you know, that is a, you know, really ripe fruit we should visit. Guess what happened there? They didn't even open the door. Can you just believe that, you know, we were, they're looking at me, maybe they could recognize I am his, you know, son's friend's father, might have seen it. They said, we are so busy inside, I don't know what they're doing in the 3 o'clock, but I was totally taken aback, but I think this is where when we were thinking, I have a connection, probably is a good thing, absolutely not. If Srimad Bhagavatam doesn't want to go there, it will not go, period. Does not matter. And second one, the very first home when I joined, we went to we asked the door, you know, ring the bell, and the Shankar, the Prabhu, his name, he installed the video camera outside just because there was some robbery in that neighborhood. And the moment he opened the door, he went deep inside. He never even checked up how many people are walking in from our congregations. So we were like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I mean, all were going in, and he was not even worried about the security for which he has put a security camera. How could this be possible? This is not possible. That person was, I mean, unbelievably ready. It was like a Srimad Bhagavatam was telling, okay, go take me right there in their home. That's it. His wife, she was sick. She couldn't even stand. The one thing which he said, it really struck me hard, was like, he said, I just need to go to the room. I can't even sit, but I will miss you this discussion. She was relishing that discussion. Forget about, you know, Bhagavad Gita, you know, Srimad Bhagavatam reading, or, you know, she, how could that it be possible? This is all Srimad Bhagavatam's own will, free will, where she wanted to go. We are just a mere instruments, and we pray to Krishna, please take us to the right source. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. From, I think, past 3 weeks, we are meditating, or 1 month now, to how to do this SOS, and we advertise too much, and and they are coming here, and how to take them out. And it's a real test to take all devotees out. And we hardly praying, and Vaisheshika Prabhu said, even if they won't distribute, said, that doesn't matter. You are just going and presenting Bhagavatam. That itself, it's a great thing. So try and depend on Krishna. So that's how we end up today by 12 sets. Is because of all of you are here and the energy is here. Thank you for that. Hare Krishna. And so today, I think first for 1 hour, we, myself, Anjan Prabhu, and then Bal Mukunda and Mataji, we are knocked many, many doors. And you won't believe, I thought, okay, this is a test today, for sure. So the first door, who took Srimad Bhagavatam? Actually, they didn't take it initially. His birthday party going on. And his father is supposed to cut the cake. And we went in. So please wait, we are cutting the cake. I said, no, please come. This is a good time to take Srimad Bhagavatam. But, you know, he came out and opened the door, and I said, I am not into it. My wife, she is very much interested. You can talk to her. And then she said, let's finish the cake because these kids are already hungry. And we end up, okay, we'll put the Bhagavatam. This is a birthday gift. And we'll come back and tell you what it is. And she said, okay, just we'll put the Bhagavatam. And we came back and we are having prasadam there. And the lady came back again. He said, I changed my dress. You won't remember me. You came my home. I says, I remember you. And then she said, okay, you want something? You are doing very good service. I can get something from home. I was so happy because, you know, we don't know her first of all. I saw only 5 minutes, and she's already giving, offering help for us. And we went back around 6 o'clock to her home, and we did a Srimad Bhagavatam installation, and they gave $500 donation just to. Why I'm saying, because all devotees with me, they are very enthusiastic, especially Anjan Prabhu and Mataji, Bal Mukunda, and Madhukari Prabhu. He's a golden hand. Wherever he knocks, they take Bhagavatam. So we are knocking, he's knocking all the doors. The one good part is Anjan Prabhu learned how to back it up now, and I learned from him. He talking to people and balancing the team with me actually. And one thing I learned from Mataji is that we went one home, they are very, very receptive, and she asked us to come invite, and they took Bhagavatam. But her husband was not there. She said, I have to call my husband, but he's in the flight, but let me take. And she took Bhagavatam. There is something spilled from that in the kitchen. And our Mataji, I cannot pronounce your name, can you? Sorry? Veronica, right? Yeah. So she said, and let me help you. And she was so happy that she's already, and somebody, we are outsiders, we went to their kitchen and helping them. And finally, we installed Srimad Bhagavatam there. So, and also I would like to thank all the devotees who came so long. And it's actually East Coast time, right? They're like, now it's midnight for them. It's almost, right? 9 o'clock. And all devotees. And also, Mataji's helped in the cooking. Hansapriya Mataji and Bharani Mataji. Then
what's the other Mataji?
No. The Manjaris. Yeah, the servers like Rasa Mataji. They are
under one more Mataji. You know her?
Okay, she is new, but they are all standing and helping in background and to make this event. We'd like to thank each and everyone. And by last, Rajesh Prabhu. He's a transport man. So he got from last night, we are thinking to make these teams. It's very tough to make these teams, Chaitanya team. Like, you know, we don't know how to make it. He said, don't worry, get a pen and paper, let me figure it out. And he made all the teams with sitting together. And all his plan today went well. Even though Pleasanton, we are many people, but by Krishna's mercy, it came out wonderful Sankirtan day. Once again, thank you. Thank you from my bottom of the heart.
I knew it's a very long day. It started at 8:30 a.m. and it's almost 8:45, so 12 hours. So you might be very, very tired. So I think maybe it's a good time to... Well, we won't disappoint you because we have tomorrow also. So I think you can just get some good rest tonight. And then tomorrow morning the seminar starts at 8:30 a.m. So be in temple before that. And tomorrow also there will be field trips. So we'll figure out whether we'll go for Bhagavatam or for Street Sankirtan, Motel Gita, Kit Sankirtan, different avenues. So we get to choose. So I think thank you so much. And we also want to thank all the leaders today who led different teams. I don't think without the leaders we would have done anything. So the leaders were Shraddha Mataji, Mukharvinda Prabhu, Shivakumar Prabhu, Harivamsha Prabhu, Sundar Prabhu, Haladara Rupa Prabhu, Kumari, Leela Mataji, Shyamalangi Mataji, Ram Sundar Prabhu and? Oh, Ram Sundar Prabhu alone. And then we have Vittal Prabhu going with? Alone? Krishna Karuna Prabhu and Vittal Prabhu. And then Koladvipa Prana Prabhu, Shri Krishna Purushottam Prabhu and Madhukari Prabhu. Yes. All right. I think we can stop here. Vanchi Kalpataru Vyascha. Also, we forgot one most important thing. There was a broadcast going on since morning. The morning program was broadcasted and even the evening program, it's done by Jai Kanai Prabhu and morning was done by Ramananda Sakha Prabhu.
Oh!